everybody. It's a crappy day out. It's snowing. Go Vermont. So I thought I would show some crappy movies from my collection. First up, we got Bottom Feeder. Tom Sizemore. I believe this was around the time where he did some drugs and a porno movie came out with him in it. So he was pretty much doing anything for money. You need that drug money. Basically, he ends up fighting a rat man. I know I watched it, but it wasn't very good. Calm down, Cap. They got Half Past Dead. Steven Seagal. It's always good for some crap, some cheese movies. They got Ja Rule. Remember, he gets whole idea is he's half past dead, and they bring him back, and he's pretending to be a criminal, but he's a cop. Go to jail. What the fuck, Cap? All Souls Day. Danny Trejo. I mean, I love Danny Trejo, but he's done a lot of shit. And this is one of them. There's zombies. Your standard group of people end up somewhere and shit happens type movie. I remember towards the end, I made a joke. I was watching this with my friend Tim, and I'm like, a girl's gonna disappear because she's a ghost. And then she did. And we kind of looked at each other like, what the fuck? I hadn't seen it before, but yeah, the girl in the end's a ghost. Spoiler. Latin Dragon. Bought it basically because Lorenzo Lamas and Gary Busey are bad guys. This wasn't complete crap. It was more cheesy, funny. This guy looks and sounds like Ray Romano. And so he's the Latin version of that. Good or bad, that's up to you. House of the Dead and House of the Dead 2. Probably everyone's seen this Uwe Boll movie. As I said in my other one, he's always good for some shit. Sequel, I think he produced it, and people he's worked with before wrote it. It was horrible. Sig Haig was in it for like a second. The only thing that was like remotely interesting was a guy got bit by a mosquito and he slowly turned into a zombie. But they didn't do anything with it that was like a second. Like, oh, what? It might turn out to something. No. Another Lorenzo Lamas movie. Probably see where these are going. Rapid Exchange. Also got Lance Henriksen. Also has been in a lot of shit, but I still love him. This was like, they hooked a wire between two planes and were stealing money. I don't know. One of those things where you're watching, you're like, what the fuck? The Rage, again. Lorenzo Lamas and Gary Busey. But this time, Lorenzo Lamas is a good guy. And Gary Busey is a bad guy. Who apparently had sex in Vietnam with a girl who had razor blades hidden in her vagina. And it fucked his dick up. So there's one scene where he's like, I can't remember if he did or he's gonna finger fuck a girl. I didn't see the point of it. But then he has to come save the day. And then this, he's supposed to be a good guy, but he's like, you can't go in. And then he punches him and, yeah, whatever. If you want a good laugh, definitely check out that one. It's like, hey, again, what can I say? He's done some shit. Night of the Living Dead 3D. This is not 3D, though. You get your glasses open. I did watch it. I watched it with Tim. Awful. Awful, awful movie. I think there was three, maybe four gags with the 3D. One involved punching a zombie in the face. He's driving like a motorcycle like this. And the other three or two or whatever it was just pot smoke gags. I'm blowing pot smoke at you. Woo! Bought this for $1. Undead or Alive. Zombie. Western. I have never found him funny, ever. This didn't change it a bit. He was funny maybe twice in this movie. shit. So, some crappy movies for crappy days. I hope you enjoyed that. It was a nightmare.